Hi everyone, it's the Skincare Nerd, and today I want to talk to you about one of my very favorite things about skincare, my very favorite ingredients, which are antioxidants. I cannot get enough antioxidants. They're so important, especially when you're trying to prevent damage to your skin. So even if you have perfect skin, you need antioxidants. If you have damaged skin, you need antioxidants. If you have oil, you dry skin, everybody needs antioxidants because they're so wonderfully amazing for you. What do they do? So antioxidants fight off free radicals. We get free radicals from the sun, from pollution, from tap water, from the computer screen. They're literally everywhere, and they just attack and are really, really harmful to the skin. And antioxidants just help fight those off. So I have a little demonstration that I'm gonna show you, which involves candy. But this is basically how free radicals are formed and how antioxidants protect your skin from them. So everything that exists physically is made of molecules. And those molecules are made up of atoms. And each atom has two electrons. So here's our two electrons right here. For whatever reason, every once in a while, one of those electrons will go away. Now you've got a free radical. And it misses its electron. It's trying to find another electron to replace it. So you've got your healthy skin over here, your two electrons and your atom of, maybe it's collagen, elastin, you know, whatever part of your skin this atom happens to be in, but it's got its two electrons, so it's nice and healthy. So the free radical comes along, and it's like, hey, I'm gonna steal one of your electrons. So now you're left with damaged skin. This could be a wrinkle. This could be sagginess, this could be discoloration. Literally all the signs of aging could be associated with this damaged atom in your skin. So what an antioxidant does, let's put the skin back together and let's get our two electrons from our antioxidant. So you've got your skin with your antioxidant on it. Your free radical comes along and it's like, hey, I'm gonna take one of these skin electrons. The antioxidant is like, no, hey, free radical, take one of my electrons instead. So your skin is still nice and healthy. You still got those two electrons in your skin, and you've got some extra antioxidant for any more free radicals that comes along. So really important in the prevention of skin damage. Knowing sort of which products and what to look for when you're looking for antioxidants can be tricky because they don't always say that they're an antioxidant. But what I like to do is just think of all those things that like health professionals and nutritionists and people tell you to eat or drink to prevent disease or when you're already sick to help you get better. The major one that comes to mind is vitamin C. However, vitamin C is such a huge deal in skincare and it's so complex. I feel like it warrants its own video. So I'm gonna do that video separately. I'm not gonna go into vitamin C in this one, other than to tell you that it is a powerful antioxidant. And oftentimes paired with vitamin C is an ingredient called echinacea. So in like cough drops and those little powders, the vitamin C powders that you put in your water bottle will oftentimes also contain echinacea, which is a type of flower. And really any flower is gonna have antioxidants in it. You've got a lot of skincare made with rose and lotus and orchid and camellia. Those are all gonna have antioxidants, but I really wanted to concentrate on the echinacea because there's this fantastic brand called Pharmacy that actually developed their own strain of echinacea that's really, really high in chytric acid, which is the antioxidant. They call it Green Envy. It's in all of their products. I've never met a pharmacy product I didn't like. They're literally, all of them are amazing. This is their Sleep Tight. So this is their nighttime balm. We'll get it to where you can see it. This is probably their best-selling product for a good reason. I've got these little cleansing grains for exfoliation. They also have a brand new cleansing balm, which I'm dying to get my hands on. As soon as I get paid, I'll probably get that. They also have a couple products made with honey. So what's cool about this is that they keep their apiary right next to their field of echinacea. An apiary is where you keep bees, if you didn't know that. So the bees come out, they pollinate all the echinacea, they go back, they make their honey, that echinacea is infused into the honey, and then pharmacy makes it into a mask and a salve, but I just have the mask here, the honey potion. And this is wonderful. This is one of my favorite things. Bee ingredients in general are some of my favorites, and I'll definitely be doing a video just about like honey and other bee products. So that's definitely one of my favorite products. Another thing people tell you to drink to prevent illness is tea. Any kind of tea is going to be super high in antioxidants. I drink a cup of tea every morning. It's a combination of green and black tea, and I put some honey in it, and I rarely get sick. And when I do, it's just for a couple days. So tea is in a lot of skincare. You'll find it a lot. Origins has a line made with white tea. It's called The Perfect World, and I think they just repackaged it and might have reformulated it. So it's sort of getting relaunched right now, and it's kind of their focus. So if you're in like an Origin store or a counter, they're probably going to have it featured somewhere. Ole Henriksen has his cleanser, his foam cleanser, that's made with red tea. And then Fresh, where did I put my products? Fresh has their black tea line. I've got little babies of the age delay cream and the instant perfecting mask. So they've got masks, they've got creams, they've got toner, they've got a serum. These products are just absolutely wonderful. They smell good. And they do everything as far as not only preventing aging, but also for people who have already started showing signs of aging, it helps for them as well. And then green tea is used a lot in products. I really, really love this product from Blythe, the Soothing and Healing Green Tea Splash Mask. It says it's for more oily or combo skin, but I have dry skin and I was fine with it. I actually really loved it. You can see it's empty. I used all of it. And I think out of their three splash masks, I probably like this one the best. But it exfoliates, it tones, it cleanses, it does everything. And then you just stand in the shower and pat it for 15 seconds. Super easy. There's also a product, a cleanser, another foam cleanser from Neogen that you can actually see at the bottom. It has like full leaves of green tea. Which are just constantly being infused into the formula, and that's a really great cleanser. You've also got green tea in a lot of sheet masks. This one is from Innisfree. This line of sheet masks is really fantastic. And then this one is from Asfolia, which is a little easier to find in stores. I think I got this one at Forever 21. The Innisfree one I had to order. Another way to figure out if something has antioxidants in it is to think of superfoods. They're usually very buzzworthy. There's like every other month, there's a new, like I think a couple years ago, it was pomegranate, and then it was acai berry, and then it was goji berry. So just think of superfoods and what you'll sort of find at like Whole Foods and with nutritionists and what they're gonna tell you to eat a lot of. Coconut is a superfood, and a lot of really great skincare products are made with coconut. Kopari has their coconut oil. You'll hear people talk about coconut oil all the time, especially for the skin on your body and for your hair. And this one is literally just organic coconut oil. However, Kopari did do research into which type of coconut was the best for skin and hair, and that's what they use. So it's really formulated. I mean, you could cook with it if you wanted to, but it's really made for use on the skin and hair. Glam Glow has their hydrating mask, which has coconut in it. So this can be used as a 10-minute mask, or you can put on a thin layer and wear it overnight. Either way, it's super hydrating, and my dry skin just eats it up. And then one of my favorite brands, Herbivore, has some coconut products. This is their rose hibiscus coconut water mist. And that's one of my favorite things ever. It smells amazing. Any berry is going to be considered a superfruit. I mentioned acai and goji berry, I think. The only skincare product other than sheet masks that I found that had berries in it was this from Ole Henriksen, their blueberry blackberry enzyme mask. Now this was he recently went through a full repackage of his entire line. So this is now in a purple jar, and I think it's called something different, but it's still the same formula. And anyone who like is into nutrition, makes a lot of smoothies, will tell you that blueberries are one of the highest in antioxidants that you can get. I also have a couple sheet masks. We've got the pomegranate ones. Oop, that's not pomegranate. The pomegranate ones from Misha and Mizan. This one I had to order this one I got at Target, so this is definitely becoming more accessible. I've got a blueberry from It's Skin. If you've never tried these It's Skin masks, you've got to. They're absolutely amazing. A blueberry one from Holika Holika. And this one I think I got it at TJ Maxx. So I was super excited about that. You've got the Leaders Cranberry that I got from Ulta. So again, really accessible. And then here's a few that I got at Forever 21. Nature and Pure Smile. These are strawberry masks. And then I also have the Skin 79 strawberry. And this actually looks like a strawberry when you put the mask on. So if you follow me on Instagram, you've seen me in this mask, and it's kind of hilarious. So other superfoods other than berries that you're going to want to look at are green things. Just anything green. Spinach, kale, broccoli, cucumber, green beans, celery, just green stuff. It's all going to be packed with antioxidants. And one of my new very favorite products, and this is a little baby version that I got, is by Youth to the People. And it is their kale, spinach, and green tea moisturizer. So I've already talked about tea, but this also has the kale and the spinach, which are your leafy greens, which have your proteins, your antioxidants, super healthy for your body, also super healthy for your skin. And at the bottom, you'll notice it has some hyaluronic acid as well, which, if you've seen my video on hyaluronic acid, you know that I really, really love that ingredient. And I'm definitely going to be getting the full size of this once I finish this little guy. I've also got a product from Origins called Buy All Greens. This also has a little bit of green tea in it. It also has spinach and spirulina. And spirulina is becoming more popular amongst people who like to take like vitamin supplements and stuff like that. I don't know how it is to eat. It might be gross. I don't know if you'd want to put it in a salad or anything. But it's another leafy green. And this is a cleanser slash mask. You can also use it to take off your makeup. Really good product. You've got a green product from First Aid Beauty. This is their Vital Greens Face Mist. So you can use it just to hydrate throughout the day, or you can use it to set your makeup. And this has, it says aloe, spinach, raspberry, cucumber, all sorts of things in here that'll provide you with antioxidants. Fresh has a couple of products that have cucumber. Cucumber is really great because not only does it have a ton of antioxidants, but it's also an anti-inflammatory, so it calms the skin. So if you've got any redness or irritation, cucumber is a really good ingredient to look for. Their entire Lotus line has cucumber also in the formula. And as I mentioned before, flowers are antioxidants as well, so that Lotus is going to provide even more antioxidants. And then my favorite cleanser in the world, the Soy Face Cleanser, also made with cucumber. And it occurred to me while I was collecting all my stuff to make this video that I should test the pH balance, or the pH level rather, of the Soy Face Cleanser. So here's my little strip. You can't really see it, but it is a nice healthy 4. Low pH is good when you're talking about cleansers because it won't strip the skin. So if you have sensitive skin, oily skin, dry skin, any type of skin, this is really, really good for you. And then Peter Thomas Roth also has a line with cucumber in it. This is the gel mask. You can use it, again, as a 10-minute mask or as a sleeping pack. He also has like a moisturizer and a cleanser, I think, and like eye patches that use cucumber in it, which are all really, really good. I've got some cucumber sheet masks. This Cocoa Star is really cool. It's actually like, it's not a full sheet mask. It's like little patches that are shaped like cucumber slices that you put all over your face. Pretty sure I have a picture of me wearing this on my Instagram. So check that out. Another one by Innisfree. And another superfood that's becoming really popular in skincare is avocado. This It's Skin Mask is like the best thing in the world. I absolutely love it. I've also got an Ariel avocado mask, and then Sephora Collection has several. This is the hand mask, but they also have it for the face and the eyes and that sort of thing in avocado. So you'll also hear, you don't want to limit your green things just to things that grow out of the earth. There's also some really great products made with green things from the sea. Seaweed sheet masks are becoming increasingly popular. You've got the Wakami mask from Boscia. We've got, and I got this one at Sephora, and the seaweed mask from Skin Food, which I got at Ulta, so they're both super accessible. Didn't have to order those babies. And then we've got algae. So algae really became popular when the brand Alginist came out. I think they were originally trying to make like a sports drink or something. And they discovered that the hyaluronic acid was actually really amazing for your skin. So they shifted their focus over to skincare. They've got this whole line, which are really wonderful products. All of their products are going to have the hyaluronic acid, which is the antioxidant in algae. Their Genius line is going to probably be the most powerful as far as anti-aging goes. And one of my very favorite products from them is their Sublime Moisturizer. It just has this beautiful sort of pink iridescent glow to it. It looks really gorgeous under makeup, and it feels really great too. And then Peter Thomas Roth also came out with an algae product. This is one of my favorite masks. Again, you can use this as like a 10-minute mask or a sleeping pack. I've used it as both, and I've loved it as both. I would definitely recommend this. And then another thing a lot of health professionals will tell you is, I'm sure you've heard this, drink a glass of red wine every day. The reason being is that the grapes in there have polyphenols and resveratrol, both of which are very powerful antioxidants. Also, if you watched my video on fermented ingredients, you'll know that fermentation increases the potency of the ingredient. And so that's why they recommend red wine over just like eating grapes or something like that. And there's a really great brand called Caudalie that uses resveratrol and polyphenols from grapes in their products. They started out as a vineyard in France and then again shifted their focus over to skincare when they realized that the ingredients they're using were really good for the skin. They've got some really popular products, their mists. This is literally just organic grape water. I actually, when I was, I had a cold a little while ago, and I actually would like spray this on the back of my throat, and it would make my throat feel a lot better. Because there's nothing in it that would be, in any way harmful. You've also got their beauty elixir, which is like a cult favorite. They also have their green line. This is one of the old ones, the polyphenol line. They've repackaged and reformulated, so it's in a lighter green bottle now. But that's the line that's going to have the most antioxidant power as far as Caudalie goes. And then there's just some like other random ones that I had that I felt like I should talk about because they're becoming more popular and I really like the products. So seeds have a lot of antioxidants, and chia seed is becoming more and more popular in skincare. This is the OG, the Face Shop chia seed line. I've been dying to get my hands on the toner. I just haven't gotten around to it yet. And I think Perricone also has a new serum, new-ish serum, that has chia seed in it. Argan is really popular in skincare. You'll also hear it referred to as Moroccan oil. But the best line is Josie Maran. This is an old bottle, so they don't look like this anymore. But her argan oil is first cold press, so it has all of its nutrients. And you'll find argan oil in every single one of her products. We've also got Dr. Jart with the Sikapear line. So that tiger grass is a really great antioxidant. And I love this product. It's a color corrector, so you might not be able to see it, but it's actually green. This is the product I wear on my days off when I don't feel like wearing makeup. It just evens out my complexion, has SPF in it, is super moisturizing, and it has those antioxidants that I love so much. So this is one of those products that I just can't live without. I buy it over and over, because there's nothing that compares to it. And last but not least, I couldn't make a video about antioxidants without mentioning my baby. This is my Christmas present to myself. I absolutely adore this product, but it is a splurge. This is the Golden Crocus Elixir from Carez. So this is made with a type of saffron that is grown on the island of Crocus in Greece. And this particular type of saffron only blooms once a year. So it's extremely rare. They say on the little info sheet that they give us that it's more rare than gold, more precious than gold, because it only blooms that one day a year. So they harvest it that day, and the very next day it's put into the formulation. So it's super fresh, has all its nutrients, all its antioxidants. And this product also has peptides and some hyaluronic acid. It smells like heaven. You can use it as like a pre-serum, or you can use it as your serum. And anything you put on over this is just going to work like a million times better. It's just a wonderful product, and if you have a chance to get your hands on it, I definitely would. It's one of my absolute favorites. But that's all I have as far as antioxidants. If you have any questions, or have some antioxidant products that you love that you'd like to recommend, I love recommendations. Just leave those in the comments. Make sure you subscribe, and also check out my Instagram. I post a lot more on my Instagram than I do on my YouTube. So you can keep up with sort of what my routine looks like and what products I'm buying and new products and stuff like that. It's at skincare.nerd. Check that out, and I will see you next time.